Welcome to Optical Fiber Communication Playlist. Here in this session, I'll be going to explain optical amplifiers. And to explain optical amplifiers, these are my session outlines, where first I'll explain you basics of optical amplifier. Then we will see types of optical amplifier with its working and application. I'll conclude this session based on optical amplifier. So let us begin this session with first agenda, that is basics of optical amplifier. So see, as name indicates, optical amplifier, that is used to amplify optical signal. So in optical amplifier, we will be amplifying optical signal, not electrical signal. So in case of optical amplifier, it is not necessary to convert optical signal into electrical and then provide amplification. So this is not an optical amplifier where we do conversion of signal into electrical one and then do amplification. So this is not the case which we do in optical amplifier. In optical amplifier, without having conversion of signal from optical to electrical signal, we do amplification of signal. So basically in optical amplifier, we amplify optical signal only. Optical amplifier performs amplification without any conversion. Optical amplifier can be placed anywhere in optical length to provide amplification. So we can use optical amplifier anywhere in length of optical cable. So based on position, there are multiple applications which is there with optical amplifier. So I'll explain you different applications so it will be more clear how we can use optical amplifier at different position. So all those things that we'll be discussing later in this session only. See, optical amplifier are bidirectional. So it is not like optical amplifier is working in one direction only. It will be bidirectional. So in both of the direction, it will be doing amplification. So optical amplifier, that will be bidirectional. And optical multiplexing is also possible by using optical amplifier. So optical amplifier are bidirectional. So this is very important. Bidirectional amplification is happening. And optical multiplexing is even possible by using optical amplifier. So that means optical amplifier accepts many signal of different wavelength and it provide amplification. So when we talk about basics of optical amplifier, it should be clear principle of working, that is to amplify optical signal. And here one thing that we need to take care of, that is by using optical amplifier, we don't convert optical signal into electrical and then do amplification. Here in optical amplifier, we just amplify signal which is there in form of optical signal. We don't convert that into electrical one. And one more important point that we should know, that is optical amplifier are bidirectional. So optical multiplexing is even possible. It accepts many wavelength and provide amplification. So these are the basics which is there with optical amplifier. Now let us see types of optical amplifier. So when we talk about types, then there are broadly two types of optical amplifier. One is semiconductor optical amplifier, and that is even referred as SOA. And second is Raman optical amplifier. So semiconductor optical amplifier and Raman optical amplifier, so these are two categories which is there in optical amplifier. There are some other category even, but broadly usually these two categories are there. So we can say two types are there. One is semiconductor optical amplifier and Raman optical amplifier. I have made a separate session for both in detail, but here I'll explain you some basics of both. Semiconductor optical amplifier are small in size and it gives amplification by using stimulated emission, which is similar to laser. So semiconductor optical amplifier, that is small in size and it gives amplification by using stimulated emission, similar to laser. And Raman optical amplifier, that use a phenomenon of Raman scattering to have amplification of signal. So basically two categories of optical amplifiers are there: semiconductor optical amplifier and Raman optical amplifier. Semiconductor optical amplifier, that is small in size and it does amplification by using stimulated emission as per laser, which we have already seen. And Raman optical amplifier that uses Raman scattering principle to obtain amplification of signal. Now let us see different applications of optical amplifiers. So see, based on position of optical amplifier, there are various applications. So here I have optical transmitter and here I have optical receiver. And see, I have used this optical amplifier over here, which is somewhere in between this transmitter and receiver. So this is what inline amplifier. So this application is even named as inline amplifier. So in between somewhere of transmitter and receiver, if we use optical amplifier, then these are inline optical amplifier. And the basic purpose of this application is to increase distance in between transmitter and receiver. So if we have long distance transmission in between transmitter and receiver, then somewhere in between we can place inline amplifier so that we can improve strength of signal. So for example, after some distance of kilometer, if signal strength is weak, and then inline amplifier will boost that and you will find signal strength will improve, and now this signal can further propagate for some other distance. So this is to improve distance transmission in between transmitter and receiver. Now second application, that is preamplifier. Now what is preamplifier? See, when we transmit signal and when it reaches to optical receiver, sometimes it is very weak, and if receiver sensitivity that is not up to the mark, like see for example, if I say I have received signal that is there with minus 50 dBm, right? And if receiver sensitivity that is minus 30 dBm, in that case we cannot extract information. So at receiver side, if we use optical amplifier, then that is preamplifier. So before we give it to receiver, we amplify it and it will improve sensitivity of receiver. So preamplifier, that is even one application. So that is been utilized at receiver side. So amplifier is connected at receiver side, and see, this amplifier at receiver side will improve sensitivity of receiver. Now third major application, that is transmitter booster. Now see, sometimes it is like we don't have such physical situation in which we can provide inline amplifier. So all we can do is we can provide amplifier at transmitter side, or we can have amplifier at receiver side. So I have already explained you, at receiver side if you use it, then that will be preamplifier. But if you boost signal at transmitter side, like see, if I say I have signal which is not that strong, then at transmitter side, if I use this optical amplifier to boost the signal, then that is referred as transmitter booster, and that is to provide signal transmission to longer distance. So transmitter booster, that is even one application where if it is having some situation in which we cannot connect optical amplifier because of some physical situation, in that case we can use optical amplifier at transmitter side so that we can have that communication to longer distance. So at transmitter side only we are using it, so it is what, transmitter booster. And one more application that is there, that is signal booster. So in signal booster, obviously the purpose is to amplify signal. So we are amplifying this signal, right? But the purpose is different. Like, see, if we need to send signal to multiple users, in that case, by this weak signal, it is not possible. So all we do is we make it strong by using amplifier, and then we can broadcast it, or we can send it to multiple user by using star coupler. So here I have used star coupler, and this star coupler that will send this signal to multiple users. And even for broadcasting, we need strong signal, so signal booster is required. So we can use optical amplifier to have signal booster, and that could be performing operation to send signal to multiple user. So this is even one application. I hope that you have understood this session. Now in next session, I'll explain semiconductor optical amplifier and Raman optical amplifier. So it will be clear to all like how optical amplifier are functioning. Thank you so much for watching this video.